हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम नेत्रावती कांकर, बीएड फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट टीचर फ्रॉम केएलएस कॉलेज ऑफ एजुकेशन अंकोला. इन टुडेज वीडियो लेसन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द ग्रामर टॉपिक करेक्शन ऑफ एरर्स. लेट्स बिगिन. सो व्हाट इज दिस एरर आइडेंटिफिकेशन और करेक्शन ऑफ एरर्स? It means usually general mistakes what we perform while speaking or while writing is called common error. It is an error that goes against the rules. Many of us tend to commit mistakes while framing sentences which you don't realize. Grammatical errors come in many forms and can easily confuse and obscure meaning. Generally, these mistakes are committed in the following areas. Some common errors are with using appropriate articles and prepositions, using correct form of verbs, placing words in the right order, errors in subject, verb, agreement usage, mistakes in apostrophe usage, pronoun disagreement, mixing of spellings, errors in tense usage, etc. All right, let's begin with articles. What are articles? Articles are words that define a noun as specific or unspecific. English has two articles, the and a or an. The is used to refer to specific or particular nouns, whereas a or an is used to modify non-specific or non-particular nouns. We call the definite article and a or an the indefinite article. Many of us tend to commit mistakes in the use of articles. So let's see a few of them. Here is our first sentence. I have a appointment. Is that correct? No. It should be I have an appointment. Why? Because A is a oval and the word appointment, it gives oval sound. And in front of oval sound, we use article an. Next example. This is a best thing to do. Is that correct? No. It should be this is the best thing to do. Best is the superlative degree of comparison. It always goes with the best thing to do. Article the, it is always used in front of superlative degree of comparison. Any superlative form like the best, the worst,
the oldest, the most beautiful, etc. needs to have the in it. Remember that. Next example. Radha studies at an university. So what about this sentence? This sentence looks correct, but it's not. The correct sentence is Radha studies at a university. But hold on, you might be thinking university starts with U, which is a oval. So we should put an before it, right? Well, no. The rule is that you put an before a oval sound, not a oval letter. The word university starts with year sound. We don't say university. We say university. The year sound is a consonant sound. So, no an before university. Let's move on to prepositions now. So, what is preposition? A preposition is a word or group of words used before a noun, pronoun, or noun phrase to show direction, time, place, location, spatial relationships, or to introduce an object. Some examples of prepositions are words like in, at, on, of, and to, etc. Mistakes are often made by using the wrong preposition after certain words. So let's solve few examples of them. The first example is there was a quarrel among the two girls. Is that correct sentence? No, it should be there was a quarrel between the two girls. Why? Because when you're talking about only two people or things, use between, and if you are talking about group of three or more people or things, use among. Here is our next example. He walked over the stage. So what about this sentence? The correct answer is he walked across the stage. Why? Because over is used when there is an idea of crossing something high, whereas across is used when you refer to crossing a level surface. Next one, they left without say goodbye. Is that correct sentence? No, it should be they left without saying goodbye. Why? Because verb immediately following prepositions before, after, since, when, while, despite, without, for, always take the ing form. Next example. I have been in America since 3 months. Is that correct? No, it should be I have been in America for 3 months. Because preposition for indicates the length of a period of time. And preposition since is used for a precise moment in time. For example, for 20 minutes, for 3 days, for 7 months, for 4 years, for a long time. And since it is used as since 9 a.m., since Monday, since March, since 1998, etc. Next one. I came to office by walk. It is not the correct sentence. The correct sentence is I came to office on foot. Why? Because we use preposition by to show how someone travels. We can say by car, by bike, by train, and by flight. However, we cannot say by walk as it is the food which is being used to travel and not walk. Next example. The snake was killed by a stone. Is that correct? No, it should be the snake was killed with a stone. Why? Because we use with to talk about instruments with which something is done. Let's move on to word order. What is word order? Word order refers to the way words are arranged in a sentence. The standard word order in English is subject, verb, and object. Word order is very important in English because if you make mistakes in a sentence, sometimes it can be changed the whole meaning of a sentence. Let's solve few examples on it. Here is our first example. Why you are so late, John? This sentence is incorrect, right? Why you are so late, John? Okay, and one thing you should keep in your mind that if you find question mark in the sentence, and it should be in the form of question itself. And you are not supposed to change the sentence or word order in the statement or any sentences. So what is the right answer here? The right answer is, why are you so late, John? It is not why you are so late, John. The right word order is, why are you so late, John? Next one. Open page 35 of your book. Is that correct? Again, The word order is the problem in the sentence. It is not the correct sentence, right? The correct sentence is, open your book to page 35. Why? Because open your book is the first thing that you say. To page 35 is the second thing that you add to this sentence. So, the right answer is open your book to page 35. Let's move on to mistakes in apostrophe usage. You know that apostrophes are used to indicate missing letters in contractions. For example, can't is short for cannot, don't is short for do not, it's is short for it is or it has. Let's solve few examples on it. Here is our first example. I don't believe it's finally Friday. Is that correct sentence? No, it should be I don't believe it's or it is finally Friday. Why? Because it's is a contraction of it is or it has. Contraction means a short form of word. You should use an apostrophe with its only when the word means it is or it has. Without the apostrophe, its means belonging to it. Next one. Do your homework or clean your room. Is that correct sentence? No. The right answer is do your homework or clean your room. Why? Because your indicates possession and you are is a contraction of you and are. Okay. I hope you all understood. So that is it for today's class. I am going to meet you all in the next class. We have plenty more examples with plenty more grammatical errors with concepts. I'll be discussing more about grammatical errors in English in your next class. Let's meet in the next class. Until then, keep practicing. Thank you.